Good morning all of you. Today this video is going to be my third video on the chapter quadratic equations. In the last video already you have checked so many equations that whether they are quadratic equation or not with the help of general form. Now today in this video you are going to learn a new topic, namely as solution of a quadratic equation. Solution of a quadratic equation means we have to find the roots of the quadratic equations. But before that, we have to make sure maximum how many roots a quadratic equation will have. To understand it, let us recall again the general form of a quadratic equations. We know the general form of a quadratic equation is x square plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c all are real numbers and obviously a not to be 0. Here we see the maximum power of x is 2. So obviously we can claim a quadratic equation will have maximum 2 roots, not more than 2. So here it is confirmed a quadratic equation will have maximum 2 roots, right? Now the roots of a quadratic equation can be found by using three methods. The first method is method of factorisation. The second one is by completing squaring method. And finally, the third method is by using quadratic formula. We shall be learning every methods one by one with proper examples. Now, today in this video, we shall be learning the first method, method of factorisation, with suitable examples. Now, let us do it. Now, let us understand what is the meaning of factorisation method. In this case, the roots of the quadratic equation can be found by using middle term factor. That means, in this case, we have to express the quadratic polynomial in the left hand side into two linear factors. After that, the values of x means roots can be found very easily. I hope it will be clearly understood if we work out one or two examples. So let us work out one or two examples here. Now here it is the first example. Now we have to find the roots of this quadratic equations by using factorisation method. That means by using middle term factor. Here the left hand side is 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equals 0. Here we have to do middle term factor. Means ultimately we have to bring the two linear factors. From here we can find the values of x very easily. Already we know how to do the middle term factor because we have been learning it from class 8. So here let us recall again. First see here the coefficient of x square is 2 and the constant part is 3. First you have to multiply the coefficient of x square to constant part. So it becomes 2 into 3, that is 6. Now you have to split 6 in such a way that we shall be getting minus 5 in the middle. Okay. Now this 6 can be factorized as 1 into 6 and 2 into 3. Correct? Now if you take 1 and 6 and if we do minus or plus, we can get minus 5 in the middle. But here, the problem is that 1 and 6 are not matching with 2 and 3. That's why we cannot take this one. It will be a problem. If we take 1 and 6, it will be a problem. So, it is cancelled. Now, let us come to 2 and 3. If we take 2 and 3, also we can get by minus or plus minus 5 in the middle. Also 2 or 3 are matching with them, so it is acceptable. Now this 2x square and this minus 5x can be written as minus 2x minus 5x. Minus 3x. Therefore I have used this 2 and 3 here. Correct? Plus 3 equal to 0 as it is. Now, taking 2x common from the first two, we get x minus 1 factored. Similarly, taking minus 3 common to bring the same factor. Correct? Now we have got two same factors. Means we are going in the correct way. If somehow, if we got the different factors, means we have done something wrong. We have to recheck again. But here we have got two same factors. We are happy. Okay. That means we are going in the correct way. Now, taking x minus 1 common from the whole, it becomes x minus 1 into 2x minus 3 equal to 0. Correct? Dekho, ultimately, we got two linear factors that I said earlier, and both are multiplied. So, you can say from here either x minus 1 equal to 0 or 2x minus 3 equal to 0. Correct? From here, we get x equal to 1. Let us bring 1 on the right hand side. And here, it becomes 2x equal to 3. Let us bring 3 on the right hand side. Correct? Here, x will become 3 by 2. So, here we got x equal to 1. Here we got x equal to 3 by 2. So, we can say x equal to 1 and 3 by 2. Here, these are the required roots of the given quadratic equations. And we have solved it by using Middleton factor or factorization method. Understood? Now, let us take another example. Now, similarly, we have to find the roots of these quadratic equations by using factorization method. Right? So, you have to proceed in the similar way like before. First, we have to multiply 3 to 2. We get 3 into 2, 6. Now, we have to split 6 in such a way that we shall be getting minus 2 root 6 in the middle. Now, this 6 can be written as root 6 into root 6. Right? This 6 can be written as root 6 into root 6. Now, we have to bring minus 2 root 6 by using these two factors. Right? Now, let us rewrite. 3x square, this minus 2 root 6 can be written as minus root 6 minus root 6x. Though, we have used these two roots. Right? Plus 2 equal to 0 as it is. Understood or not? This 3 can be written as root 3 into root 3, x square as it is. Now, this 6, root over 6 can be written as root 3 into root 2, x. Similarly, it can be written as root 3 into root 2, x as it is. And this 2 can be written as root over 2 whole square. Understood? Now let us take root 3x common from the first two. It becomes root 3x minus root 2. Correct? Similarly, taking minus root 2 common from the last two to bring the same factor, we got root 3x minus root 2. We have got the same two factors. That means we are going in the correct way. Now, taking root 3x minus root 2 common from the whole, because it is the common, it becomes root 3x minus root 2 again 0. So, ultimately, we have got two linear factors that I said earlier, and both are multiplied. So, they will become 0 individually. either first one is 0 or also second one is 0. Either first one is 0 or second one is 0. From the first one, we get x equal to root over 2 by root over 3. Because both are containing square root, so we can put a single square root. So here we got x equal to root over 2 by 3. In the similar manner, here root over 3 is equal to root over 2. Only x will be root over 2 by root over 3. Like that. So let us take the single square root. So ultimately we got x equal to 2 by 3 again root over 2 by 3. Eventually they are same because we have got here two same factors. So ultimately we have got two roots of the given quadratic equations by using Middleton factor. Understood or not? So here we have seen how to find the roots of a quadratic equations by using factorization method in these two examples. Now I am giving you two homeworks to be done. Now we have to find the roots of the following quadratic equations by using factorization method. Here I have given two equations, two quadratic equations. Here we have to find the roots by using factorization method. So these two questions will be as a homework. Okay, understood? So today I stop here. Please keep on watching my videos. So for these days, be safe, be healthy, and obviously stay home. Thank you very much.